Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm really excited to share with you this awesome super greens powder that you guys can make right here at home. Just using either like produce from your garden, or you can just buy produce from the store and dehydrate it, blend it up, and you have a greens powder all ready to go. So I'm going to be using a bit of both today because in my garden a lot of our produce is starting to, or has already kind of just died and passed away. Like real thing. So all that's left now is basically just kale. I do have a few cover crops growing in there just to help kind of cover the soil up and stop it drying out in the sun. So that's sort of sprouting through at the moment. But the main sort of food item that I have in my garden just right now is kale. So I'm going to be using a lot of kale today. I have a few pumpkins growing, so I'll be using the greens from them. I don't want pumpkins growing in that garden because it'll turn into a huge pumpkin patch. It'll just take over. So I often just pull them out. But rather than just composting them, I'm going to use them today in this greens powder because they have a lot of minerals in themselves. You tend to want to use them in the early stages because as they sort of grow and develop, they develop like spikes on them, which make them a bit unpleasant to eat. So you kind of want to use the greens on the earlier side when they're just really young. Yeah, so I'm gonna get started doing that today. I've already collected a few greens from my garden already, and I'm just soaking them at the moment in the water just here. So they're gonna be ready soon, and then I'm just going to wrap them up in a towel and just dab them dry, and then pop them in my dehydrator. I do also have a few store-bought greens because otherwise it'd just mainly be kale in this super greens powder, which is fine. It's a superfood itself. It's really healthy. But I wanted to add a lot of different nutrients in there. The reason why I wanted to make the super greens powder today is because over winter, we tend to get a lot of our produce, I guess, at the store, because I tend to, like, the greens tend to kind of die off during the summer, and then you got to plant them again in the autumn, and they grow over the winter. And you sort of don't have anything during that time. I want to get a lot of nutrients, especially in winter, because you tend to have the, you know, low immunity during that time. A lot of flu season kind of happening. So I wanted to make a greens powder for that time when I don't have as much produce in my garden. And, you know, I want a bit of an immune boost. So, bless you. But yeah, I have had store-bought greens powders in the past, and they are really good. The only thing is they are quite pricey. That's why I want to make my own today, because they're really simple to make and you can add in whatever you like, so you're in control of what's in it as well. And you can use up fresh produce so it doesn't have to go to waste. Especially, I found at one stage our garden was just producing so much food, which is it's a good problem to have, but a lot of it was spoiling because you couldn't get to it in time. So this is another thing you can do for that if you have that issue as well. You just get the extras that are starting to spoil, or you want to get them before they're starting to spoil, and put them in your greens powder, and then it saves on wastage as well. Let's get started. So I today have bought some spinach, some baby spinach, some Swiss chard that I'll be using as well. I also have some alfalfa sprouts. So these little guys here, little sprouts in there. They're really good. You can also use like collard greens, you can use pumpkin greens, you can use weeds, surprisingly, like clover and dandelion. The clover, whoops. Brace I got caught. The clover in my garden is just in the baby stage. Like, it's just starting to pop through at the moment. So I won't be able to use it at the moment. But when it gets bigger, I can use it in the greens powders. I also have some herbs from my garden. I think there's oregano, thyme, rosemary, a bit of viola, some mint, and then kale and pumpkin sprouts. Yeah, so that's what I'm going to be using in my powder today. But you guys can feel free to add whatever you like, any type of greens you want. I do have a list in the description below on my blog post, which I'll link in the description. A different, like all the kind of different sprouts and greens and things you can use in your greens powder. So if you guys want to check that out to get some ideas, but the sky's the limit really. Like, those aren't the only options. You can feel free to get creative and do different things as well. Like, don't feel like that's the only range of things that you can put in there. Like, go crazy. So I'll get started and showing you guys what to do. Basically, to begin with, you're gonna harvest your greens. So if you're getting them from your garden, collect them up, or you can even collect them wild out if you live near a forest or somewhere and you see some good greens to use. Edible greens, mind you, don't just get random things, but like something that's actually edible. You can pop it into your greens powder as well. So you want to start off by harvesting them, so you collect them. Then what you want to do is you want to wash them, make sure that they're clean. Just try and get as much of the dirt and stuff off as you can, but I'm not too much of a picky with that. I don't mind having a bit of dirt on there. It's good B12. So yeah, and my soil is really good. It's like organic, so I know it's not been sprayed. which is why I don't mind having it. But if you get it like wild and you think it may be spray, please don't use it. Anyway, so you're going to collect your greens, pop them into some water, clean them. Then you want to dry them so that they're nice and dry and they're not all dripping in your dehydrator. And then you're ready to dehydrate it. It does take quite a few hours. I think it's up to 4 to 8 hours, or basically until it's like dry and crispy. So it's still quite moist by the time 8 hours is up. Still keep dehydrating it, because if any moisture gets into the powder, it can cause it to go moldy, and you don't want that. So I'll get my towel ready, and then I'm gonna pop my greens that have been just soaking here. I made sure to check that there were no bugs on them while I was collecting, because it has happened to me in the past where I've collected things from my garden. You know, like, oh, yeah, good, nothing on there, bring it inside, and there's like a giant caterpillar there, and I'm like, oh my gosh. So if you are collecting from the garden too, just make sure it's been inspected for bugs as well. Yeah. And then I'm just going to dry it. Just roll it up. Try to be a bit gentle because you don't want to crush the greens. Alright, so that's done. Ready to put into my dehydrator. So I'm just going to lay it out. Try not to layer it too high, because it will... won't dehydrate properly. Like, some will stay moist because it's not getting the air sort of flowing through. So you kind of want to just place it next to each other when you're putting it on your dehydrator. Alternatively, you can do the oven as like a dehydrating option. I do share how you do that in the description below, but just for simple, like for a simple method today, I'm just going to be using the dehydrator. I've never actually dehydrated in our oven before. It's not exactly too good because the seal on it isn't strong. So I love air escape, so I don't tend to dehydrate in my oven. First layer done. So it's finished. Finished layering it all up. The Swiss chard is a bit high, so I didn't put anything else on top of it, because I think it would just keep this hanging up too high, which means a lot of the air will escape. And I won't dehydrate as well, so I'm just going to leave it as the top layer. And then I'm going to put my lid on top. So when you're choosing the ingredients, just keep in mind you want to go organic. When you're making a superfood greens powder, it's concentrated, which is excellent because you get a concentrated dose of all the nutrients and greens. However, it just means that if you get pesticide-laden ingredients, you're also getting that too. And you don't want that because it's a toxin for the body and it can cause like really nasty side effects from having too much of those chemicals in your body. So you, when you can, do opt for organic. Or if you're growing it organic, you have it already there. It saves so much money. It's great. Or you can go with biodynamic farming, or I think there's other ways. It's like other regenerative type of farming practices that they're doing now. So really try and source really good quality ingredients, because the better quality, the better nutrients you'll get and receive, and the healthier you'll be for it. So do opt for that. I think it ended up being around about 10 cups of greens that I'm using here, which makes about 16 tablespoons worth in the end. So you have about 16 doses of the superfood greens powder, which is great. So I'm going to finish it here. Now I'm going to dehydrate it. You want to dehydrate it at around, again, 43 to 51 degrees Celsius, or 110 to 125 degrees Fahrenheit. And you want to do that again for around 4 to 8 hours, or until your greens are crispy and dry. So that may take shorter time, may take longer, just depending on what greens you're using and your heat dehydrator. So it does take a little bit of time, but once that's done, that's like the longest leg done. And it's pretty quick from then on. So I will see you guys in a few hours. Maybe a bit more, maybe tomorrow. If it's 8 hours, I'll see you guys tomorrow to check on my greens, see how they're going, and hopefully they'll be all ready to blend away. Day, and I have my greens already to go. Just before we get started in blending them up, I thought I should let you know, for the Swiss chard, I think it's probably best to remove the stem part of it and just dehydrate the greens to start with, and then do these like on their own separately because they take a lot longer to dehydrate. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to blend these up later on and then just mix it in the powder at a later date. But for now, I'd just let you know that they're still quite moist. And again, you don't want to put anything moist into the greens mix because it can go moldy and it won't be very good. It won't last as long. So you want to make sure just separate the stems. I didn't realize this before, but separate the stems and then just blend up the greens part because they won't take very long to dehydrate. This took around 6-7 hours. Before they were completely ready. I didn't want them to go too far dehydrated where they turn brown and completely like burnt. So I wanted to get them in the earlier stage. So mine, as you can see, probably here as well, they're lovely dry and crispy texture. That's what you want when the, and that's when you know they're done. But for the moment, I'm gonna keep these in the dehydrator and then just dehydrate them later on. So I'll remove all the green part of it. Even the stem bit, this one's all right. But on the thicker ones, it's still quite moist, so I'm going to chop it off as well and separate that bit just on the ones that have like a thicker stem, like especially this one. It's still quite soft, so I'm going to remove that. But now we're going to get started in blending them up. So you're going to grab a food processor, which I'll just get now. Okay, so I'm going to be using a large food processor. You can use a high powered blender as well. I do have a Nutribullet, but I thought this might just get it to be more of a fine powder rather than still be, I guess, more of the chunkier side. And then I'm going to grab the mixture once it's been blended up quite a bit because this is still quite big. I'm going to put it into my small, tiny little blender here. And that will just help to really kind of create a fine powder with it. So I'm going to transfer it over later on. So mine's going to be in like two different sets. But if you just have one good high powder to be blender or food processor, you're probably right to go with that. And if you really want it to be super fine, you can also strain it out at the end and just get the more clumpier bits and keep the fine powder part and just keep blending up the clumpy bits until it becomes the fine powder. So that's also something you can do as well. Move that out of the camera shot. Let's pop all my greens in. The alfalfa and spinach can just go right on in there. The good thing about this sort of kind of recipe is that you can just do it whenever. Like if you have spare greens, just dehydrate them, blend them up, and they're good to use as a powder. You can also turn them into like a juice kind of frozen cube thing, which I've done in the past as well with extra veggies that I've had in my garden. All you do is you blend up without dehydrating them. You just blend up the ingredients with some water, or you can even add some plant milk and things like that. If you want it to be more like a creamier texture, you can add coconut milk to it. And you blend them up into like a juice. Keep the pulp as well because that's got all the nutritious fiber in it. And then all you do after that is you pop it into some ice cube trays and then you freeze them and you have these little juice cubes that you can pop into smoothies. They're not the nicest tasting things on their own because they are just plain greens. There's not anything sweet in them unless you put fruit. But they're great to use as just like to pop in smoothies as like an extra nutrition boost rather than just doing like a powder. It's another way you can do it as well. And I have done that in the past. It's good fun. I still have some left over from like last year's season of veggies. I just add them into a little cube, like one or two cubes into my smoothies. Put some milk, put some banana in, or another bit of fruit, and then blend away, and you have your green boosting smoothie. All right, so once you have your veggies, it's just like full to the rim, which is great. You're gonna blend them up. And if you can get it just with the big blender, you want to get into like a really fine powder. If you've seen a greens powder or like any sort of supplement powder, like protein powder, you know it's really fine. So you want it to get to that consistency. And again, if you want it, if it's not just getting like fine enough for you, you can just put it through a strainer, get the clumpy bits out, and then just like blend those up afterwards. So this is what it looks like after I've blended it like the first time round. It smells amazing. It smells like Italian herbs actually. It smells really, really good. So see how it has these bits of stalk from like the herbs and things? Like here. I just dropped it. So like that will be what you'll strain out later on. So I will put mine through the strainer later after I've blended it again. I'm going to blend it in just the little one now because this is as much as the big one could do. So I'm going to blend it up in here just to get more of a fine powder, and then I'm going to strain it out and just do that a few times, just keep repeating that just to make sure that it gets into more of a fine powder. So you just might have to strain it out a few times, blend it more, strain it out, blend it until you get to your fine powder. So I've finished now. I finished making the greens powder, and the little bits that I couldn't blend up, like I repeated it and repeated it and repeated it until I got like the fine powder. So you may need to do that a few times as well when you're making this greens. Just repeat it until you get a nice fine powder to use for your greens powder. But if you have leftover bits, like these are the herbs, and I couldn't get them to be as fine, so I actually just kept them in a little old herb container that I've kept from past herbs that I've bought, and I've just kept it in there because it smells like Italian herbs, and I thought, oh, this would be such a great thing just to use on dinners and things, on meals that I make. So I've just kept the leftover herbs that I've dried just to use to like sprinkle on food and things, on meals. So that can be an idea for you guys as well. So just keep the leftover bits, or you can just compost them if you don't want to do that. So you should use about a tablespoon in your smoothies when you want to use it. Now, it did make like a lot, so as you can see, like you get so many herbs, they only blend down to like a little bit. So if you want to, you can just gather more and do the same process again. They do recommend 10 cups to make about 16 tablespoons worth. Evidently, you didn't have quite 10 cups. So it's probably about 2-3 tablespoons in this. So it's a really fun process. It literally takes like a day to do, if you have the whole day to do it. And you have amazing super greens powder just to boost that body of yours, help kickstart that immune system, give a bit extra nutrients to your body, especially during the winter time. Like I already have a bit of cold coming on, so I'm going to be using this for breakfast this morning. Put it in a smoothie. So excited. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. It was so much fun sharing this with you. I had so much fun making it. Do let me know if you try it out yourself. Ellie, my gosh. Let's try that again, take two. Shelly doesn't know what I'm talking. Do let me know if you try it out yourself. She's saying goodbye, I'm sorry about this in the background. It can be quite ear piercing, her tweeting. Sorry in advance. Do let me know if you try it out yourself. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope to see you guys again soon in my future videos. Bye.